Hi guys, welcome to another Divi theme video. This is Jamie from System22 and webdesignandtechtips.com. Well, we got a great one for you today. We've got a little mega menu here and you can pop it anywhere on your site that you want to. When I roll over it, it's going to expand. To reveal the menu, you can roll over, check out your links, whatever you need to do. When you take your mouse off it, it's going to go back to how it was. You can put it up in your header if you want to. But I'm going to just create this little button for us that expands like this. Of course, you can save it and add it to any page you want. Really easy to do, so let's get started. I'm going to enable the Visual Builder. And we'll go down and we'll get rid of what we've got here. First thing that we're going to want to do is create the actual menu itself. So if you go down to your dashboard, down to Appearance, and menus. I've already got one created, but to create your mega menu, hit create new menu. Call yours what you like and hit create menu. Now to create the actual mega menu itself, we've just got to start building it. I'm going to use custom links for the heading on these, and of course pages and things like that for the internal links. So click on custom link here. We have to put a URL in there to be able to use it. So I'm just going to put a hashtag and we can remove these in a minute and I'll show you exactly how. Now this first one is going to be what it says on the little button that they hover over. So useful links or mega menu or whatever you need to say for yours. I'll just say mega menu for mine. And we can add it to the menu. There it is right there. Now we don't want them to click on this and go anywhere. So once it's over here, we can get rid of that hashtag, because if we leave it in there and they actually click on it, it'll take them to the top of the page. So once it's over here, you can remove those links. Great. And the next thing we want to do, Divi's actually got an inbuilt mega menu that lets you have four columns. So we want to start adding the titles of our next columns. And again, we've got to put something in there. So I'll put a hashtag. I'm going to say about us. In fact, I'm going to capitalize that so it stands out from the stuff below. So I'm going to say about us in capitals, and this is entirely up to you. I'm going to add it to the menu. I'm going to left click on it. I'm going to pull it slightly to the right and release it so it becomes a sub item here. And again, I'm going to go into this one and remove the link because I don't want it to go anywhere. It's just a title for the beginning of our first column for our mega menu. Now we can start adding real links to pages or wherever you want to take them. Let's just, for expediency, grab these right here. And we want to put these under this menu as a sub item to our titled one up there. And you can put as many links in under each column as you want. I think I put four or five in my last one. Once you've got enough, you want to add another custom link for your next title. And again, got to put that dummy link in there for starters. And I'm making this capital again, services. Add it to menu. Remember to drag it slightly to the left so it is a sub item, just like the one above. And once we're in there, we can get rid of that URL again. Now there's no point you watching me continue to do this till we've got four columns of links. I'm just going to switch back to my other mega menu. I'll save this one. And I'll select the mega menu that I built earlier. And as you can see, that's exactly what I did for this. I just rinsed and repeated, so I've got four columns. And you can put in as many links in each column as you want. As you can see, I put in four in each there, but it's entirely up to you. Once you're all done with this, to actually turn it into a mega menu, we've got to give it a class name. And to do that, we're doing it with this top one here that says mega menu. If you go in there, you may notice that there isn't anywhere to put a CSS class name. Well, not by default anyway. Well, you may not notice because it's not there. So to get your CSS classes to show up, we need to roll up to the top of our page to where it says screen options right at the top here. Hit the little chevron and we can select a little box that says CSS classes. Once I do that, you may see that this CSS classes have just appeared down here. and we have to give it the class of mega menu, M-E-G-A menu. Once we've done that, it's going to act as a mega menu and we can build it into our site. So once we've done all that, make sure you save your menu. It'll tell you that it's saved and updated here. We can build our little site here. I've got my page builder over here. Go to wherever it is on your page you want to build this. I'll just throw it down under these little hover images here. I'm going to add a new row. Inside my row, I'm going to put a single column. Inside the column, I'm going to roll down and put a little menu module. There we go. Now here it's going to ask you to select your menu. Here's my mega menu. If you don't see the one that you've just created in there, save what you've got going on and refresh your page. For instance, that one that I just created, MM, has not shown up here because we created it and we actually went into this builder before we created it. But I'm using the mega menu anyway, so that's fine. As you can see, that's popped in down there. If I hover over it, let's just roll it up a little bit. If I hover over it, you can see the little menus popping down like that. Perfect. Down below, you can add a logo if you want to. I'm not. I'm going to turn mine into a little button, as you saw before. And if you've got WooCommerce installed, you can choose whether to show a shopping cart icon, and you can choose a search icon as well. I'm going to leave those both off. We don't want a link because it's a menu and they're going to link to the things when they drop down here. And if you've noticed, those little buttons down there are rolling over the top. We'll fix all that in a moment. It's not a problem. Down below that, you can choose the background of the actual top bit, the mega menu part up here. I'm going to make mine blue for simplicity. There it is. Let's go over to design now. Layout wise, I want mine centered, so it's in the middle there. And you may have noticed that color's extended to our drop down menu here, but we can have a different menu for that. And again, I'll show you that in a moment. Depending on where you put this button, you can have it going downwards, or if it's at the bottom of a page or something, you can have it opening upwards like that. If I roll down a little bit so you can see it more, I'm happy with it to go downwards because it's fairly high on my page. Okay, the menu text itself, I'm going to turn that white in color so we can see it. That's the active link, and all the other links as well, I'm going to turn them all white. Fantastic. And you can see I put those in capitals. It just makes them stand out a little bit more from the active links below, because these aren't links at all. Remember, we removed those little hashtags there. I think I'll make it semi-bold just to make it stand out a little bit more. I'm going to roll down a bit. I'm actually going to add a little bit of text shadow. Just gives it a slight, little bit more definition there against the background. But that's entirely up to you. Great. Well, things are shaping up here. Let's roll on down. Don't need to change anything else there. Here's our drop down menu, and like I said, you can change the background color, menu line color. Menu line color is the black line that's in the middle there. I change that to blue and change the actual drop down background color to black, it'll just go from blue to black. And if you wanted to, you could bring the opacity down by clicking on the color, so there's a hint of the website that shows through the mega menu there. Nice little idea. You want to be able to read these nicely, so I think I'm going to have it full black there. You can change the drop down menu text color if you want to here. I'm happy with it to be whatever color, but like I say, you can make it any color you want that works for your branding. Actually, that's quite striking. Let's turn it back to white. And you've got a color for the active link, mobile menu background color, and you can change the mobile menu text color also. We've not got any icons like our cart or anything like that, or a search icon. Hamburger menu is when it's on mobile. I'm happy for it to be that blue color too. Logo we're not using. Sizing. Okay, I'm going to have a bit of fun here. I'm going to make this more into a button. So I'm going to actually go to width down here. And I think I made my last one 150 pixels. In the width here, I'm going to make mine 150px. As you can see, that's shrunk it down. But of course, our menu is not going to work when they hover over it, but we'll fix that in a moment. and I want it in the middle of the actual column that it's in, right there, it's fine. But when they hover over it, I want it to be full width, 100% of the width of that column that it's in, so we can display those items. And to do that, hover over the width, and this is common to all Divi modules. If you hover over the dark writing within a module, you'll see these little icons pop up. If there's a little arrow there, we can create a desktop state, which is what we've got here when the mouse is not on it, and a completely different value for when the mouse is hovering over it. When they hover their mouse over it, I want that to go from 150 to 100% of the width of the column. So I'm going to put 100 and the percent sign in there. As you can see, it's gone back to normal now. Desktop, we've got that. When they hover over, it's going to zoom out like that. Fantastic. Well, we're almost there now. I'm going to roll down a bit. I'm going to give it a bit of spacing just to make it more like a button. I'm going to put, say, 20 pixels on the top, 20 pixels on the bottom, and I'll give it rounded corners in the border down below. I've been using 20, so let's continue using that. Got nice little rounded corners there. And what I did, just for a bit of fun, I made it absolute positioning and put it between two little sections here, so it's halfway on that white and dark section there. To do that, really easy, we'll go into the row itself, the green tab. Going to go over to positioning in advanced, so advanced tab, down to position. I'm going to flip it from relative to absolute, and it's disappeared to the top of that actual section there. I want it right on the bottom, as you can see there, but I want to drag it down a bit till it's halfway between those two sections there. And you may have noticed it's dropped behind that lower section. We can fix that with the Z index right here. I'm just going to slide that up till it comes above. There we go. And that should work perfectly now. Let's save our changes and take a look at it on the front end. Save this. Save draft or publish if you're ready. And exit the Visual Builder. There's our little menu. If I roll down a little bit, when I hover over, it's going to drop down and show us our menu. And as you can see, that's on top of those buttons below now. And they can go on, they can click those links. When they take their mouse off, it's going to disappear back to how it was. Like I say, great little feature to have on your site there. Let's take a look on tablet and mobile. I'm going to hit my F12 key. Here we've got an iPhone 12. If I roll down, I can see a little problem there. We've got no hamburger icon. It is actually there, but we made it the same color as that background. So I'll adjust that in a second and we'll take another look. But when you click on it, it's fine. It's going to open up, show our mega menu like that. Let's have a look on an iPad. Got an iPad Air here. Let's make it a little bit bigger so you can see. And we got the same problem there. The hamburger is there, but it's blue. And we can pop down, grab our little links just like this. Click on it again. It's going to close up. Okay, well, let's just fix that little problem we've got there. I'll close that up. We'll enable the Visual Builder. I'm going to go into the module itself. Over to design and icons. And here was the hamburger menu. As you can see, I made it the same blue as the background. That's why we couldn't see it. Let's just make it white or whatever color you want for yours. We'll save our changes again now. And we can actually check that while we're in here. Hit the little purple button. Let's flip it to mobile. Roll on down. There you can actually see the mega menu right now. And it'd be the same for the tablet. Problem solved. And we'll just save our changes and exit the Visual Builder. So there you go, guys. There's how to build a little pop-up mega menu that you can add to any page or anywhere on your site you want. Just simply save it to your library, put it on another page. I hope you've enjoyed this today and found it useful. If you have, please give it a thumbs up, ring the bell, comment, share, and subscribe to our YouTube channel. Once again, this has been Jamie from System22 and webdesignandtechtips.com. Thanks for watching. Have a great day.